Time goes by, so does music. I might be 1 minute early or 1 minute late, but be that as it may, welcome. Today is, we're having Holy Week here in the Philippines, and so I thought it'd be a good thing to kind of like tap into, you know, gospel music, you know. So I know as a young boy, you know, I used to go to church, you know, we used to go to church three times a week. We used to go to Sunday school, Bible school, and I don't know what the other one was, but it was Sunday, Wednesday, I think Saturday, something like that. We used to go. And I remember being in the South, because I come up in North Carolina, a long place called Laurinburg, North Carolina. And we used to all pile into the back of the pickup truck, the typical Beverly Hills Billy type of truck that we get on that had a chair that you had, you know, you sitting on there like this. And we would ride in the church. And, you know, and I was with my grandmother at that time, and we were living with her, you know, and it was quite an experience, you know, being in church, you know. And then after church, we, you know, they had baked, you know, women had made food and all that stuff, and we ate. And my auntie, Christina, she was the piano player. She used to play and all that stuff. She was such a rebellious child, you know, she didn't want to play the piano at all, but she turned out, you know, to be quite a pianist. And a matter of fact, you know, she turned out to be an extraordinary woman, you know, so, which is good. God bless her. You know, of course, has no contact with your boy, you know, you know, one of those type of things. Listen, I still love her to death. I did some things to her, you know, that, oh, this is a Sunday show. Okay. So anyway, so let's jump right into it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to play this little clip here. And this is a little clip about the explanation of gospel music. So hold on. Let me set it up. Let me set the stage.
Now, Avery Clayton of Los Angeles, California.
And the stage is set. Okay. Oh, I hear you, but let me find it. Okay. So, okay. This is a little small clip that I'm going to throw in here just to kind of give a little bit more explanation of gospel music and where it came from. So hold on, and here we go. Again, welcome all you who are on the show, see through your watches. That's good. Glad you're on time.
By 1860, there are roughly 4 million enslaved Africans in the United States. Forcibly transplanted to a new land, they've brought with them a rich African heritage, including songs. Adapted to reflect the experiences of life of hard labor on plantations, these slave work songs, laments, and shouts of protest evolve into a new musical form, the spiritual. The spiritual will in turn become the wellspring for generations of musicians who will create the blues, gospel, jazz, and the protest songs of the 1960s. Now, Avery Clayton of Los Angeles, California, believes he may have discovered a vital link to this important music.
I was just going through some boxes in my mother's collection.
Okay, we're going to stop right there. Avery Clayton, if you want to dive into more about the treasure trove he found in his mother's belongings, I guess after she passed away, he found a book that had a lot of music and from those days, and who led to the foundation of him, you know, exploring it more. But anyway, the first group I'm going to tell you about is who I'm going to play for you is they are the Clark Sisters. Now, there are a number of gospel singers, you know, the Wymans, the, you know, Andre Krause, you know, the, you know, I don't know, a lot of them, you know, but, you know, I couldn't, you know, tell you all of them, but there's just so many. But there are a few who, the ones I picked out are a few of my favorites, ones that I like, okay? So this one here is the Clark Sisters. Okay, the Clark Sisters are an American gospel vocal group originally consisting of five sisters. And let's see, Jackie, Denise, Twinkie, Rolinda, I can't spell, D-O-R-I-N-D-A, and Karen. In the 1960s, the Clark Sisters are the daughters of a gospel musical and choral director, Dr. Maddie Morse Clark. They are credited for helping to bring gospel music to the mainstream and are considered pioneers of the contemporary gospel. Their biggest hit include Is My Living in Vain? Praise the Lord, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me, a praying spiritual, nothing to lose, all to gain, endow me. Jesus is love song, pure gold, your miracle, and their bigger mainstream hit, crossover hit, You Brought the Sunshine. I know a lot of you remember, You Brought the Sunshine. We're gonna see if we have time for that one. And as a group, the Clark Sisters have won 2 Grammy Awards and are the highest selling female gospel group in history. And in 2020, the Clark Sisters were honored with the James Cleveland Lifetime Achievement Award at the 35th Annual Stellar Award. In 2022, the group was inducted into the Black Music and Entertainment Walk of Fame. In 2024, the group, including Denise Clark, was honored with the Grammy's Lifetime Achievement Award, becoming the 5th gospel act to receive the award after Mahalia Jackson, the Staple Singers, the Blind Boys of Alabama, and Shirley Caesar. So I'm gonna jump to this first song. I was in Las Vegas and a friend of mine came through, and she came through and said, "Gerard, I want you to play this song." I said, "Okay," and I was quite surprised that she was, you know, fully mentally engulfed in this song, and it has become one of the songs that are on my list, and it's called Is My Living in Vain? And this is by the Clark Sisters. How you doing, my brother? Bob. I got a helmet. My heaven is, I can't stop serving my Lord. I'm a person. Yes, too. Yes, it is a nice weekend. Let me see if I get more light here, Bob. Hold on. Too. Instead of strips on LSD, I take them with G.O.D. And it takes me higher. And it lights my fire. Woo. Hallelujah. Some of y'all looking at me funny, you may be guilty, but you don't need no reefer. All you need is Jesus. Let me see your hands, you know what I'm talking about. Say yes! Yeah! Is you living in vain? Good. I'm glad you're here. Is you living in vain? But is your living in vain? Is your living in vain?
Up the road is eternal gain.
I'm in the Philippines.
Thank you.
Send a prayer of yours. Okay, that was the Clark Sisters. That was one of their biggest hits called Are You Living in Vain? Okay, we're going to, Bob. Yeah, man, life is good, man. You know, they say it's what you make it. But, you know, that being true, you know, you are the captain of your own destiny, you know. You know, you can always do more, you know. You can always do less, you know. But self-motivation is the key. And oftentimes I find myself lacking that in my own life, self-motivation to complete the projects I'm working on even now, okay? But before I start whining about myself, let's go on to the next artist. The next artist I'm going to play for you, and let me see who it's going to be. This is, his name is EDWIN HAWKINS. And EDWIN HAWKINS is, let me give you a little background on him. EDWIN Reuben HAWKINS, August 19th, 1943 to January 15th, 1918, was an American gospel musician, pianist, vocalist, chorus master, composer, and arranger. He was one of the originators of the urban contemporary gospel song sound. As a leader of the EDWIN HAWKINS Singers, probably the best known for his arrangement for of Oh Happy Day, the songs of the century list in 1970, the EDWIN HAWKINS Singers made a second rise into the charts, backing folk singer Melania on Lay Down, A Candle in the Rain. Whew. Okay, born in Oklahoma, raised 17, okay, together with, okay. The rest of it is more or less his educational background, but you kind of got an idea of who he is. But let me play this song here from EDWIN HAWKINS and his singers. And this is, of course, Oh Happy Day. This is Gospel Week here in the Philippines. And of course, you know, I am focused on gospel songs today. So this is what we're going to do. This is Oh Happy Day. A lot of you may remember this song.
was a war.
That was EDWIN HAWKINS Singers, Oh Happy Day. You know, I was just thinking that, you know, in the beginning I played a piece about how gospel music rose from slavery. It was singing, you know, to take their minds off of the hard labor that they were doing and had to do. And I was watching this program, and they will come talk about how blacks are killing each other and all this stuff, hey, like this. And the guy said, you know, this is all pre-designed, you know. And I don't want to get anything too far, but it's like you can't put guns and drugs, you know, and alcohol, like you did on the Indian reservation, like you did to the Latin, you know, and then, you know, watch them turning themselves, and then you don't want to know that brought the, you know, the incentive, you know, to for that type of behavior to happen, and then back away and then say, see, look how they act against themselves. But the reason I say that, because, you know, one thing that we always held on to was song. We hung on to the church. We hung on to God. You know, we blacks can sometimes be the most forgivingest people. I forgive them. We forgive them. You're like this. You know, because we know it's in God's hands. Yeah, and that's what we often do, and we often carry that pride that we are able to rise above so much diversity. You know, so much animosity, so much negativity, and still hold our heads up and to the heavens and God, and say, you know, He will find a way. Okay, so we're back. That being said, let me go to my next performer, who I'm going to share with, and this is with, let me see. I'm gonna wait till I do an intro for you. These are called the Blind Boys of Alabama. Let me see here. Let me kind of give you a little information about them. Okay, the Blind Boys of Alabama, also billed as the Fine Blind Boys of Alabama, Frontier, Fountain, and the Blind Boys of Alabama, is an American gospel group. The group was founded in 1939 in Alabama and has featured a changing roster of musicians over its history, the majority of whom were vision impaired. The Blind Boys found mainstream success following the appearance in a 1983 Obie Award winning musical, The Gospel at Chorus, at Columbus. Since then, the group has toured internationally and has performed and recorded with such artists as Prince, Lou Reed, Peter Gabriel, Bonnie Raitt, Ben Harper, and the group cover of the song, Tom Watts' song, Way Down in the Hole, was used as the theme song for the first season of what? HBO's The Wire. Okay, so with that being said, let's jump into the Blind Boys and let them do their thing. Okay. We got a glare. Let me see if it's out. There you go. Okay.
I'm too close up to heaven. Too much of it. I'm too close. Then turn back your worship. Listen, I wouldn't take nothing.
Calvin's very slow moving in the morning.
So close. I'm almost to reach my goal.
I'm glad you like it.
Lord, I'm too close.
Especially if you've been sitting smoking a joint.
I don't know about you, but that makes me mighty close.
Okay, that was the Blind Boys of Alabama. Okay, let's see who next I'm going to bless you with. Let me see. Okay, let's go with her. Okay, this next artist I'm going to play for you. I don't know why I don't put it on the big screen. Oh, well, anyway. It's Mahalia Jackson. Mahalia Jackson, October 26, 1911 to January 27th. 1972, was an American gospel singer, widely considered to be one of the most influential vocalists of the 20th century. With a career spanning 40 years, Jackson had I looked up the word and pronounced it twice through the computer, but I can't remember. Developed a spread of gospel, blues, and black churches throughout the U.S. during her time, when racial segregation was prevalent in the United States society. She met considerable. Unexpected success in the recording career, selling an estimated 22 million records and performing in front of integrated and segregated audience in concert halls around the world. The granddaughter of enslaved people, Jackson was born and raised in poverty in the New Orleans. She found a home in her church, leading to a lifelong dedication of secular purpose to deliver God's word through song. She moved to Chicago as an adolescent and joined the Johnson Singers, one of the earlier gospel groups. Jackson had hardly have heavily influenced by musical composer Tommy Dorsey, and blues singer Betsy Smith, adapting Smith's style to traditional Protestant hymns and contemporary songs. After making an impression in Chicago churches, she was hired to sing at funerals, political gatherings, and revivals. For 15 years, she functioned as what she termed as a fish and bread singer, working odd jobs between performance to make a living. Mahalia Jackson. Let's see a little Mahalia Jackson. Okay. Mahalia Jackson.
Oh, Lord, my God.
Remember, this is spiritual Holy Week here in the Philippines, and so that's why I'm doing gospel music today.
Consider all the world thou a hand has made. I see the stars and I hear your rose and thunder.
Voice. T-W-O. That was Miss Mahalia Jackson, you know, singing How Great Thou Art. Let's see who else is on my list of targets. Let me see. I'm going to do this brother here because, you know, it was only one who I can find the song, because I remember when I used to go to church with my grandmother, And my grandmother, was small. You know, she was frail. You know, I mean, but she still, she had the constitution of a Filipino woman. Just know what she had to do every day, and she did it. You know, no question, no arguing, no nothing. She got the chores done, the thing of moving the cows and all that stuff, she had to do. And when we were sitting in church, she would sing. I used to like watch her sing this one song, and it was her favorite song. And it was called "O Rugged Cross." So the only person who I could find who would sing that song was an artist called and you know, there's not a lot of information about him. His name is Bishop David Ellis. And let me see what I can find on him. Bishop Abe Ellis, a native of Chicago, was endowed at birth October 4th, 1935, with a tremendous Christian heritage. His parents and late elder Charles H. and Florence Lucy Ellis were the founding pastors of Chicago, Indiana Avenue Presbyterian Church of God, established in 1933. Bishop, I found this is information I didn't see before. Bishop David Ellis, the 11th child of their union, was born on October 4th, 1935, and was to mature in an environment of close-knit family harmony with deep administration and respect for his parents. He witnessed his father a relentless pursuit in establishing the Indiana Avenue Church, and it through the post-depression years of the 30s, the tumultuous war years of the 40s, and the post-war era. He marveled at his mother's ability to manage and care for and confront of her home and family, and at the same time shared her husband's struggle in building his church. He learned some of his most valuable life lessons from those sanctity parents' lessons that served him well in the years ahead when he began his pastoral. Okay, and you know, the rest is going on about family, not a whole lot more. Ellis was honored in 1975 with the Doctor of Deity degree, in 1977 with a Doctorate of Humanitarian degree, and in 62. Okay, so I don't think he really hit, you know, success, what we would deem success as an artist, but he was able to make his mark in the world. This is, like I said, he sung this song, "O Rugged Cross," that was one that my grandmother often played or sung. And I used to watch her sing it, and she would, "Oh, rugged cross," and she had a spit cup and like this and whatever. But it was such a song that I always remember from my childhood. So I'm going to share with you "O Rugged Cross" by Bishop David Ellis. Yes, yes, she did. I'm not gonna lie to you. It was a must-do in our household to go to church.
Him.
Especially having a grandson. So never know in
my heart. The old rugged car. Yeah.
Okay. That was Bishop David Ellis. And yeah, I know. I know. It's troll. Just let him go, Bob. Just let him do his thing. Okay. Let me see. This next song, this next artist I'm going to tap into is... Oh, okay. You know, there are this woman here I met several times, you know, being a personal photographer, Al Sharpton. She would often come to the National Action Network and perform at whatever function that he was doing at times. And she would sing to him. And this artist is, hold on. Is Shirley Caesar. And let me give you a little background about Shirley Caesar. Okay, let me see. Shirley Caesar, born October 13, 1938, known professionally as Shirley Caesar. Her name is Shirley Ann Caesar Williams. As an American gospel singer, her career began in 1951 when she signed to Federal Records at the age of 12. Wow. Throughout her seven-decade career, Caesar has has often been referred to as the first lady of gospel music and the queen of gospel music. Additionally, she has won 7 Grammy Awards, 15 Dove Awards, and 14 Stellar Awards. Okay. So let me see. Caesar has released over 40 albums. She has participated in over 16 compilation and 3 gospel musicals. Mama, I Want to Sing, Mama 2, and Born to Sing. Okay, so let's hear Shirley Caesar. This is one of the songs I chose to play for you. And it's called I Remember Mama. Vance, what's up, Vance? Waiting on you, my man. Waiting on you.
I remember Mama.
You remember Mama, man?
And the love that she gave.
Yes.
Kneeling by her bedside, I can still hear Mama say, "The people are depending on you, Shirley. Don't
hey, baby,
let
do you.
Them down.
It's okay. Do you?"
I remember Mama in a happy.
Just pray all is well with you, friends. All is well. Yeah.
To school with holes in our shoes. We didn't have much, but the Lord.
No matter what we went through, no matter what she did,
Mama kept the family.
You can always find something pleasant to remember your mother by. Real quick, Bob, when my mother passed away in her will, she left these words, and I'll never forget. I'll never forget till the day I die. She said, "If only reasons be known to me, I leave my son Gerard nothing." Yeah, I remember Mama.
Is it bad? It might seem empty, but it was more than others had. Yes, you did it. And I remember Mama.
chat sometime, Bob.
She's right here in our hearts. We all want to pull together.
Yes, yes.
And stay in the holy place. What?
Oh, so she's, yes, yes.
In a happy way.
Oh, wow, Wago. Oh.
In a happy way.
Okay, Bob. So you come here incognito, I see.
When I was about 12 years old, I was going to church, playing church. How many of you used to play church? Let me see your hand. Yeah, some of you still play. And I remember, I go down Mount Calvary, that's where I belong. And I jump and I shout and I come back home. But I was still disobedient.
Bob, I bet you know I was a preacher.
And one day, we decided that we want to play church. Let me tell you what we did. We went out in the back and started playing.
I remember this, playing church. These games.
And my brother was a pastor. Me and Andy, we were the members in the church. And let me tell you something. It's hard to come in contact with Jesus and still be the same. I don't care who you are. I don't care. You can be the chiefest of sinners. You will never be the same. And I've forgotten I've been going down to the church, playing church. Came home still disobedient. Didn't want to wash the dishes. Didn't want to bring the clothes in off the line. Didn't want to do anything. Mama said, I'm sick of you going down to that church playing with God. Minute and that, we went outdoors, we started playing church. Sat down on the bottom step. My brother was a preacher, and we were the members in the church. And he put some old glasses and put them right here on his nose. And he said, I want you to jump up and shout Jesus three times. And I jumped up and I shouted Jesus two times. But when I jumped up the third time, something got a hold of me.
When the spirit hits you.
She said, Mama, so Shirley is out there playing with the Lord. Mama came to the door. But she looked out there and saw me shouting and dancing all over the backyard, tears running down my face. It's just a lie.
That's right. When the
Mama
spirit
looked out there
you.
And she said, she ain't playing this time.
Tears to a brother's eyes. Oh man, the little girl that gets the spirit in her. Gets the spirit in her. And that was Shirley Caesar. You know, I remember Mama in a happy way. Okay. I was telling you, I wasn't joking that I told you I was a preacher, Bob. Let me see how much time we have. Okay. I'm not going to be able to hit everybody who I thought I was going to hit, but let me show you a video of my preaching days. I know you. Some of you might enjoy it. Well, I wasn't really a preacher. I played a preacher, and on Broadway. So some of you may get a kick out of this. But let me see. Watch later. Okay.
Elizabeth,
this is my performance on Broadway, New York City. You know, I was in a play, so yeah, I was an actor. Yeah, so I can say, and I performed in an off-Broadway play. Here we go.
You better be dreaming about becoming the first female African American president. Because all your past failures, right, Bob.
Thanks, Bob.
to be insane. Mm-hmm. Yes. I got a passport to the world for the Lord is when I preach the gospel. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get God's bubble?
God's
bubble.
Right here. Yes. Oh, right, Pastor.
Y'all don't hear me now.
Oh, we can hear you.
Well, I'm your blessing to on my deathbed.
Oh,
yeah. I'm your blessing, God's children. I'm the box and getting the word out about the Lord. Because when life happens, I said, when life happens, you got to have God on your side.
Amen.
Are you hungry for Jesus?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
I know there's someone out there doubting my God, but we need to put things in the right perspective.
Thank you.
You need to get out of yourself and into God.
Yeah.
I know many of you come here in anger, many in love, some don't believe, and some out of sheer curiosity. But you made it.
Yes, that's right.
Hey, you made it.
That's right. I made it. We made it.
When you're in need, no matter how near or how far.
Oh, get the gab. I was wondering what that was, Bob.
Oh, hallelujah.
I thought it was some type of Irish term.
Yes.
Our church home may be small, but it's full of the Holy Ghost. Your purpose and your destinies are real.
Right.
Yes. God knows where you are in life and what you're doing.
Yes, he does. Thank you, Lord.
You can
thank
hear from you. The earth, but you can't hide.
Not at all.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, I know I've broken your laws and I've put a lot of my past sins before you. But Father, I'm really, really sorry, and I ask that you let my past life be behind me so I can move my life towards you.
Yes, Lord.
Father, I believe that your son Jesus Christ died for my sins, was resurrected from the dead, is alive, and is listening to my prayer today.
Yes,
yes. Father, and I ask that you let your son Jesus Christ rule and reign over my heart from this day forward.
Oh,
Lord. Father, I also maybe ask just that watching you please send your Holy Spirit. Tell me, do your will and obey your will from this day forward.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Broadway,
now repent.
Broadway, they call it.
And every one of you will be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
For the remission of your sins. And through that, you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Trust in God. Delight in God. Commit to God.
Yes.
Is anyone out there ready to commit?
Oh, my God.
Are there any visitors here today?
Oh, bless the king.
Any business?
Oh, my God.
I arrest you.
What?
Come on.
Yeah, Who the hell?
The IRS will make any pastor jump up and head out to church. The IRS are here. Ah! You know, I'm almost at the end of my hour. I am at the end of my hour, but because I'm in the Philippines, I'm going to pay homage to this this one church. Now, I also spoke there, you know, because I have my motivational program called Dreams Are Nothing More Than Plans Awaiting Action, and I go to places and I do motivational speaking. And the church was a very small church. It was kind of like in... It was kind of like in a dugout kind of thing, you know. I mean, you walk down the steps and it's a building there and what have you. And, you know, I watched this young girl see the spirit, speak from the spirit. And the song she sung was a song that touched me. It is a blessing when you can feel the spirit of when someone is speaking to you in a different language, to actually feel connected and feel that you understand, You understand what they're giving thanks for. You understand what they're praying for. You understand what the blessings that have been put on them. You know, and this young girl is the epitome of that. It's a little long, and I thought about chopping it up, you know, like this, but no. She first prays in her own language, which is Bisaya, I think, and then she sings the song. And the song is a very simple song, but you can see it touch her soul. You can see how she feels. You know, and I actually fell in love with this girl. My God, I wanted to see her more and more and more. As a possibly a grooming her to be an artist, you know. I think at the end of the service, I think I gave her 500, and she was like shocked. Like I said, probably the most she's ever gotten for one of her performance, I'm sure, and still has been the most she probably ever gotten to perform, because I never wanted her to forget me, and I wanted to make a difference in her life, because sometimes that's what you do. I do with people, is try to make a difference in their life. You know, I try to give them something that 5 years from now, 10 years from now, you know, they'll turn to one another and say, hey, you know, you remember that guy, Gerard? I wonder what happened to him. You know, he was a really nice guy. You know, I remember when he did this for me or whatever, but he always had a smile. He talked to animals all the time. I asked Mia one time, I said, Mia, you know, what can you tell someone about who I was? And she couldn't say it. I said, look, you have to tell. I have animals throughout Dumaguete that I go on my way to stop and say hello to them. They're in cages or whatever, and say hello to them. And you know, because, you know, I don't want them to forget me either. Okay, so with that being said, let me cue this first, because I'm going to cue it where... you know, I want to play it because I know it's kind of long. Let me see. And I'm putting this up here primarily for the Filipinos, you know, also, like I said, you know, when something moves you spiritually, you know, when something touches you, you know, you can't ignore it. You know, it's a touch from God. So she's gonna speak first in her language, and then she's gonna sing this very simple song with so much emotion, so much feelings, so much praise. This may really put you to sleep, Bob. God, give it up for the a miracle, or something that's happened in her life that's changed her life. She's probably telling you how God has worked in her life. Okay, Bob. Can it still be here? UJ, whoever you are, welcome and goodbye, I guess. You can tell that this community didn't have much. All they have is each other. The belief. I love this song. Here we go. A little simple band. A little simple dancers. This is a very popular song in the Philippines and churches. dream about this little girl here. Not in a sexual way, just how talented and how spiritual she was and what she was feeling. How she's putting everything of herself into what she's singing. I gotta help her up on the bed. Thank you. free. That's giving me a child. That's giving me a family. That's giving me love. I like to think so. Follow along with it, or it opened your heart enough to hear what she was saying. See, Bob writes, write a song and get a few records made, CD, DVD, get them to record a new song. I know it's a hypocrite. No, I'd like to go back there and see them, or see her, see how she's done. You know, okay. So anyway, I'm well past my time. I have a full day today. I'm taking a family to, I don't know, some water park. You know, it's going to be very interesting. 15. Talk about you don't marry the girl, you marry the family, huh? Okay, so thank you for watching and listening to my Sunday morning classics. Stay tuned next Sunday. And we'll see what I have for you. And don't forget, Gerard Black in the Philippines with your truth. Okay? Remember, dreams are nothing more than plans awaiting action. Never disrespect the Elliot, always pull someone up. And sometimes, you're the only one to see your vision. And if you're lucky enough to have a woman like Ali Woodson, formerly singing a Temptation One song, treat her like a lady. And ladies, if you're lucky enough to have a good man like me, make him feel like a king. Okay? And never say no. Okay, I love you like a love song, baby, and a gospel song. I'll see you next Sunday. Peace. Oh, Wes Hart, you came at the wrong time. Well, go and enjoy the day. Thank you, good luck, and happy Easter. Oh, is today Easter? Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess. Let me go out and look for some eggs. Peace.